Cincinnati. It's the AFC Wild Card Round of EA Sports.
Chase,
team guy.
And the Buffalo Bills. EA Sports coverage of the NFL playoffs brings us to a very loud and a sold-out Paul Brown Stadium in Cincinnati, Ohio. Coming up, it's the final game of Wild Card Weekend, and we've got a good AFC matchup in store between the Buffalo Bills and the Cincinnati Bengals.
Yeah, guys, welcome back. Today, Bills Bengals, not much to say.
Hello, everyone. Welcome to the postseason on EA Sports alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn. And Charles, that's really all I need to say to get you fired up. It's the postseason on EA Sports.
And no one's more fired up than the guys who are going to be playing in this game. This is what they fought for all year long. Go back to the OTAs, the mini camps, training camp, throughout the season to get to the playoffs. Intensity level will be off the charts.
And he opts to not bring this one out. The first drive will start at the 25. The Buffalo offense coming out, and it is Josh Allen who is at the helm.
And we can talk all we want about football being a team game and leaning on different parts and aspects in order to get it done. And that's entirely true during the regular season. Some weeks it's the defense, the special team, running the football. But in the playoffs, all the pressure reverts to the quarterback, and he has to play well and play at a really high level in order for his team to win.
First down, and they're going to throw with Allen. It's a short one here, complete to the tight end. He'll be dropped after a gain of about six across the 30 to the 31. 4 yards remain for second down. Allen. He's got it complete to Stephon Diggs. Pass the 20.
Diggs.
Home for a Bills touchdown. Stephon Diggs, 69 yards. And the Bills will strike first here in this wild card matchup.
69 yards.
They talked about stringing together some explosive plays here in the playoffs. That was a pretty explosive play.
It certainly was. And if you're going to win on the road, it certainly helps to have big playability in your hip pocket.
Bills
win
my lot of 69 yards. Zach Taylor, one pass, he didn't get any. Why did he get his game to go already?
And it's now a 7-0 game. That drive started on their own 25. Two plays, 75 yards later, into the end zone. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. Williams now on the return. Mistake on the lateral. It's a loose ball. That was just picked up by the Bills. And they're going to be set up in the red zone at the 15.
As that ball got away from him, he saw the opposing team recover it.
You felt his pain?
Oh, I felt his pain, and you know what was going through his head. Tuck it away. Take care of the ball. All the things he hears all week in practice, he didn't carry it over into the game.
Bengals had a great season. Might have been a good year. But their offense is really good. Their defense sucks.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Devin Singletary with his first carry of the game. And he is into the end zone for a Buffalo touchdown. Devin Singletary, a 15-yard touchdown run. And the Bills are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Just an unbelievable start. Less than a minute in, they're already up two touchdowns.
You talk about getting out of the gate fast. I mean, beyond fast. That's warp speed, isn't it? To jump up with two scores like that in less than a minute's time, your confidence has to be elevated.
I haven't even found the right height for my chair yet. I'm still adjusting.
You mean you found a way to sit down?
I did, yeah. I guess I got that accomplished.
I'm still standing watching this occur.
Extra point by Bass, up and good. And that'll make the score 14-0. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. On the return, Williams. A good effort on the return there. Gets it across the 30, up to the 33. Here are the Bengals on offense, and here is Joe Burrow ready to lead them at quarterback.
And he comes into these playoffs bringing a team that's been battle-tested, won the division,
oh,
and
my
earned the home playoff game here in Rock 1. But every year they know the division champion feels like gets beat. They don't want to be that team. They have to avoid the overconfidence and make sure they play the same way they played during the regular season.
Another guy I like on the... I really like on the Bengals is Ja'Marr Chase. I did a quiz to see which Wookiee I was most like. I was most like Ja'Marr Chase. Since then, I've always liked him. And then he showed up in all my dreams, which is really funny. So now, he's called Dream Guy.
And with passion.
Burrow going to lead up the Bengals here, first and 10 at the 33-yard line.
Burrow.
There's Burrow.
The Dream Guy.
Man open, that's Ja'Marr Chase.
Dream Guy. Dream Guy. Wow, Dream Guy. There goes Dream Guy.
Chase,
9 yards.
And the Bengals strike quickly here for 6 points.
Well, there's no doubt that this offense was in desperate need of a quick answer, and they got it. One play, and they're right back in this game.
Because you got the sense if they stalled out here, and then another score on the other side to make it a 3-score game, could have gotten ugly. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and that'll cut the lead down to a touchdown. So after the main field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. Back on the field now comes the Bills offense. And right now they're saying, hey, let's keep this going. 2 drives, 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, you can't ask for a better start than that, can you? I mean, this is the way you practice it. This is the way you rehearse it. But right now, the play calling, they're locked in really well.
First and 10, and kind of tipping their hand at running the ball. 3 tight ends are out there. Allen now looks to throw. That's caught by his tight end, Dawson Knox. And he'll be taken down before they work it across the
fancy
field. A good pickup there, 26 yards. Left side caught by Diggs. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. The Bills passing game, get him down the field. They've got another first down. Quick as he throws there, incomplete. Now the defense going to use the first of their timeouts. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They work again from the 38 on 2nd and 10. To the air, Allen. He's got the hookup with Diggs. Touchdown, Bills. Stephon Diggs with his 2nd touchdown in this opening quarter. And the Bills will extend their lead. Still first quarter, 2 receiving touchdowns for him. How are they going to slow him down?
I think they're thinking about altering their game plan. Whatever they came in with, now maybe you switch a better cover guy to him. Or you make sure you have more people in his general area wherever he lines up to at least try and discourage them from throwing the ball to him.
That's reported by Bass, up and good. And it's now 21-7. The drive summary, 4 plays, 75 yards. And it ends in a Buffalo touchdown. After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away.
See some dream guy action.
And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback.
Dream guy, dream guy. Oh, doesn't even show them coming out. Oh, see some dream guy action.
The Bengals drive about to get going. And following that long touchdown pass, a one-play drive last time. See if the defense, you know they're ready. They don't want that to happen again.
And you would have thought they would have been ready the last time. Okay. I mean, that's what you work on all the time. Make sure that no one gets behind you. That's the cardinal sin of defense. Not giving up the long pass. They did. Let's see how they adjust.
A pretty wild first quarter. 21-7, our score. So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Burrow throw. And he will find his man Chase.
Green guy, touchdown.
Chase with his second touchdown here in this first half. And the Bengals have got it back to a one-score game. Now he's having a nice little first half here, partner.
That's a first half that leaves us anticipating what can still come. I mean, 2 touchdowns already here through the second quarter. There could be plenty more before this game is over.
That landmines.
And McPherson on for the extra point. It's up and good. This becomes a 21-14 ball game now. That drive started on their own 25. 2 plays, 75 yards later. Into the end zone. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. This will be returned from deep in the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. Here comes Josh Allen and the Bills offense back onto the field. He's showing off that arm, showing it off very well. They've got the lead. Don't forget, though, about the protection he's had. The protection's been good.
And I guarantee you, he hasn't forgotten about it at all, because that's keeping him clean in the pocket, allowing him to step into throws and make those deep passes come true. I mean, it's just been beautiful for him to do. But guess what? In the huddle, on the sidelines, guarantee you, he's thanking the big guys at front for keeping him safe.
The Bills come to the line to start their next drive. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. 16. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it could be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
A big hitter to start the drive has him up near midfield here for first and 10. And he finds his man, that's Sweeney. Now he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. This ball complete to the tight end, Sweeney. All the way home for a Bills touchdown. Tommy Sweeney, 31 yards. And the Bills will add on to their lead.
And what a weapon he is at the tight end spot, because when they throw him the football downfield, they count on him getting additional yardage almost every time. And that's exactly what he did there. Caught that, ran with it, all the way to the end zone.
And now Sean McDermott's made the call. They'll go for 2.
2.
Now Little try to throw for it. Looking end zone, but it's incomplete. Caught
2-2-8. Pretty good. 228 passes by True.
That was one of the other things you're concerned about when you throw that route, is to make sure your offensive linemen use their leverage to get the hands of the defensive front down so you can throw it through that little bit of crowd and get it to the receiver. In this event, they did, but a nice play by the defender knocking it away.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. The Bengals going to take over late in this first half. As they'll take over with just under a minute left to play until the break.
That's cut my video right there. Oh, Von Miller's in the Bills.
So here's a first and 10 now.
Jamar Chase, Joe Burrow, two best duo. As I say that, Burrow's going to pass someone else.
It's his crowd, it's Boyd. He's at the 30. 10. And he is finally out of bounds, just shy of the 5, all the way down at the 6. The defense, they weren't fooled on that post route. They just couldn't make the play.
And the offense definitely tried to fool
them. Third down, fourth down.
Combinations, didn't you?
It's a fourth down, I just don't have enough time to do it. So I'm being lazy and kicking a field goal at first down instead. So that's fourth down. And 69.
So as it turns out, a two-play drive resulting in the field goal. So the 3 points there in CD, that helps him inch a bit closer.
Yeah, when you're losing, any points you see go on the board in your favor, you're happy to take them.
And from deep in the end zone, he's going to bring this out. And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked out officially at the 21. Josh Allen leads the offense out for their next possession. And how about the start so far, Charles? 3 first half touchdown passes.
And that's how you generate excitement on a team. Keep your offense moving at a really high level. And it's also how you establish leadership by playing that well. 3 touchdown passes, that's the way to lead.
Now he's just hoping for number 4. Allen now on first down. Oh, Allen cannot get away, and down he goes. Tyler Shelvin able to take him down. It's a loss of 3.
Traditionally, as a defense, your number one job, stop the run. But in today's football, it's impacted the opposing quarterback, make him uncomfortable. And so far, they've not been able to do that.
Not at all. He's been really comfortable in the pocket. 3 touchdown passes already.
So that could be an important first sack if they do want to turn things around.
But following the sack, they'll try to change their fortune here on 2nd and 13. And Diggs has it. He's at the 40. 20.
Oh, God.
And he makes it all the way down to the 31.
Well, it's halftime, guys.
So
I think it was
going to happen. AFC Wild Card. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. Third quarter. Here we go.
Halftime. I can't. Did you keep skate?
Both teams trying to avoid being one and down in these playoffs as we start the second half of this AFC wildcard game. From the end zone, here comes Williams. And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of 1 there. The Cincy offense about ready to go here on their next drive. And they're on the short end of the scoreboard here. Charles, what adjustments, if any, do you think they need to make for the second half?
We're paraphrasing the guy. There he goes, outside!
Jamar Chase is just great
right now. Jamar Chase signing his best for the playoffs with his third touchdown of the game.
Dream guy!
Right out of the locker room and score here in the opening minute of the third quarter. It's been quite the game for him individually. A trio of touchdown catches now.
So pick a route, any route, whatever you want him to run, he's going to do it and do it well and end up in the end zone. This has really been fun to watch.
McPherson on for the point after. And the lead is down to a field goal now. And Sterling made quick work of that. Ultra quick work. One of the fastest drives you'll ever see. Just one play resulting in the touchdown. So after the main field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. Oh, this could be the mistake on the lateral. It's a loose ball. So a teammate picking him up there, that was nearly disaster.
And the way that you coach these things, you want to make sure you have eyes towards the return guy because you want to make sure that the catch is secured. A lot of teams do that. They have at least one guy. Okay, you're responsible for making sure he secures the catch. He's not always the one that makes the recovery.
And the defense has it covered. It's intercepted. Picked up by Mark Hilton. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. That was just one of those interceptions from our perspective here. We got a good view at the 50-yard line mid-level. The quarterback and receiver were not on the same page.
Just by his reaction, I'm talking about the quarterback, he expected something different from his receiver. Whether he expected him to break in, out, deeper, shorter, they'll determine that on the sideline. But bottom line, you can see that he thought he'd be in a different spot. Except the defender was not his intended target.
On first and 10, Joe Burrow. Throwing outside, complete to Chase.
Dream guy! It's a touchdown! The Bengals take the lead. Dream guy!
The end zone. That's what it's all about.
McPherson now for the extra point. And that will make this a four-point game. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for six. Touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And not willing to risk another fumble, he'll sit on this one. It's a touchback. Here comes Josh Allen and the Bills offense back onto the field. He's likely still kicking himself from the interception last drive that wound up leading to a go-ahead score.
And he's going to assume all that came with that one, all right? That's all on him. But he also knows he's got to erase it from his mind and get back out there. This drive, very important.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. Steps away to his left.
Oh, no. Allen.
A good gain on first has him set up with second and just a couple of inches now from the 29. To throw, it's Allen. Dancing to his left. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Now Allen. Forced out to his left. He's got his target. It's the tight end Knox. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. And a dangerous throw there as that's knocked down and incomplete.
there. That should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Third quarter of a tight football game as we come up on a second and 10. And that's complete to Adams. Touchdown, Bills.
Oh, yeah, they had Devontae Adams. Wow.
Yeah, I saw it. Didn't record for some reason. Bills got a touchdown. Let's hope this records.
After the touchdown, Bass to kick it away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Bengals drive about to get going. And they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the side.
And he is going to be taken down. And that should be the final play of this third quarter. A.J. Epinesa able to put an end to that play, and in so doing, puts an end to this third quarter. Second and 17. Another try to get the first down set. That's complete to Chase. Sheds off the tackle. And he makes it all the way down to the 31.
And this is obviously a spot where you lean on your stars. Get the ball to them in open space and let them do what they do.
So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Meanwhile, Burrow's throw taken in here by Chase. Touchdown! Jamar Chase, 31 yards. And the Bengals are once again going to retake the lead. What a game this has turned out to be, and what a touchdown right there.
How about when scheme and talent match up? Because they absolutely had to have that one. They had to find their way into the end zone to take the lead. They get it to their wide receiver. He gets that done for them. And now they get to look at their defense and say, guys, make it stand up.
Now that's the only way it would have been put to deal is if you put it in the end zone with 1 second or 0 seconds on the clock. But the Bengals can't be choosers.
Not at all. And who's going to want to deal with that anyway? Go ahead and score while you got the opportunity.
So after the main field goal, here's McPherson to send this one away. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be stopped right around where he would have been had he gone down to a knee, maybe a yard shy of there at the 24. Josh Allen in the offense now. Down by 4, 1:24 to go. It's got to be a touchdown here, and that won't be easy. On the road, in the playoffs, as they've got it with a first down. Allen, buying time to his left. That's taken in by Knox. 7 yards, the pickup there. This complete to Diggs. Stephon Diggs! And down to the 15. Excellent, excellent. execution, and now they're set up nicely.
Are they ever red zone? I wonder what the next play call is going to be, because after a big play like that, a lot of teams like to use the momentum to launch another one.
Line of scrimmage, the 15. It's first and 10. Throwing is Allen. Being chased out left. And able to get him down, but he does reach the 5. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Steps away to his left. He takes it across for the touchdown, and they take the lead late in the final minute of the fourth.
Tell me, Bryson, we watched overtime where the offense works on scoring late in the game and finding a way to win, as we just saw there.
Just saw it right there. Now can they preserve that advantage that they just got? Now an important extra point here to stretch this lead to a field goal.
Oh.
He clanks it off the right upright, and it's no good. Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss.
Here
comes
Williams.
And not a very good return at all, as he won't even get this back to the 15. Cincinnati's offense coming back here onto the field. They only need a field goal. Obviously, the clock a huge factor. They'll be watching that. What do they need to do here, Charles?
Your sequence of plays has to get you out of bounds. Completions, get out of bounds, gain some yardage. Then when the clock hits 7 seconds or less, now you get a decision. Are you in field goal range, or is it Hail Mary time? Because from 7 seconds down, you don't want to take a shot that you're going to have.
And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Work to be done here on 2nd and 16 after the sack. And this throw will be intercepted. Tredavious White with a pick. And we will get a timeout with 2 ticks left. It's first and goal.
Allen just wants to touchdown
at this stage. Can officially salt this one away. And Allen is actually going to throw it here. And this will be caught. Will forget taking the knee. So late gamesmanship here as they throw for a late touchdown. The Bills are
Hold on, upset. Jamar Chase having the game of his life with 5 touchdowns / dream guy. The Bills will advance. Bye-bye, Bengals and Chase and Burrow. Next year, though, they're going to have a year, and you may even make it to the Super Bowl. Oops, I may have spoiled it. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.